How do you translate a memoQ online project on a server? Coming up. Hello and welcome back to the Freelanceverse. Thank you so much for the support on last week's specialized video. Today we're actually kicking off a two-week partnership on the channel with memoQ. Yes, memoQ reached out to me. I still can't believe it. Thank you so much for making this happen. Today I'm actually going to talk about how to translate on the memoQ server from your clients directly, and next week's video will be about the translation conference that memoQ hosts in Budapest, memoQ Fest, so stay tuned for that. If you've seen my first video on memoQ, you can click up here if you want to watch it. I've showed you the very basic functionalities of memoQ, so really locally on your laptop, if you import a document into memoQ and you translate it, export it, and that's done, right? That's really the basic workflow. However, that's not how I personally use memoQ most of the time, and also my colleagues not. Mostly we work directly on client servers. So clients send you directly a package on their server, so it never actually is locally on your computer. Now, it is very hard to simulate this process because if you've watched my first video, I purposely said there that I can't show you the server functionalities because you would see on my server page, you would see all my client servers and that would breach many, many NDAs. And of course, it's just no way I can show these publicly on YouTube. So that's why this collaboration with memoQ is the perfect opportunity to actually bring you this workflow closer, because when you will actually find your first clients, your first agency clients, most likely you will work directly on a server. So it's great that you will have seen this before once it actually happens in real life for you. But first, as you know, I would never start a collaboration with someone if there wasn't anything in it for you guys, and that's why memoQ came through with a 30% discount off of a memoQ Translators Pro license. It is important to mention that this discount only applies to actual licenses being bought as a first-time buyer, so not for the renewal of the SMA, the agreement. It's only for the first-time purchase of a memoQ Translator Pro license if you buy it in the next 2 weeks. For that, just apply my code BA0622_freelanceverse_30 in all caps at the checkout window, and 30% will automatically be deducted from your total price. This offer is valid for 2 weeks after this video goes live, so if you've been thinking about getting the license, now would definitely be the time to do so. Go to memoQ, I'm gonna put the link down below, go to the checkout, go through the whole process, and in the end, add my code BA0622_freelanceverse_30 in all caps for a 30% discount. Now let's get on with the video. So here we go, you should see my screen, I'm in my email inbox. As I said in the intro, today I'm gonna talk to you about the workflow if an agency, mostly it's gonna be an agency, sends you a project, a translation project, directly on the memoQ server. So this is what it looks like if you get assigned a project in memoQ. You get this automatic notification, Dear Adrian Probst, the new project has been created in memoQ server, running at memoq.com/freelanceverse, that's the one I created specifically for this video, with documents assigned to you. Now you as a freelancer, if you buy the Translator Pro CAT tool version of memoQ, you cannot create projects on a server. That's a TMS, that's a whole different system. We are using the Translator Pro product, which is a CAT tool, but memoQ per se is a translation management system. So that's why you get this automated email. Once they launch the project on their server, they go out to the translators, to the reviewer, and to the reviewer too. You can, up to two reviewers you can assign in the workflow. Then you can either, well, the easiest way to open a package is just simply double click on the little attachment that comes with it. I always do it like this. If for some reason you already have memoQ open, you can also just go on the server, log in with the data that you get from your client, and then check it out. But the easiest is double click on the attachment. That's what we do now. And memoQ will open and you will get a little, oh, it's on my second screen, wait, let me drag this over. To get the pop-up window that you are on the server URL, you have to make sure, well, if I opened here, I would see all the servers for my clients. I don't want to show that, so I am already on the correct one because I clicked on the package. There is one test project that I tried out before this video, and then there is the Freelanceverse English, German, Switzerland project created today and deadline on Friday, right? You already see the deadline here. If some agencies don't use the memoQ deadline feature, but if they do, it's very neat because you already see when you have to deliver it. And then what you need to do, it's now for me, it's in German, but this means out This means a checkout project. So I will click on here, project checkout, and it checks it out from this client server. So now the project is checked out and everything is on the server. So no, nothing is locally on my PC, but all is included. You see the document is included. You see the workflow that you are assigned to, which is translator for me. Here you see the role you're assigned to, and you see the deadlines for the translator and the reviewer. So the translator has to deliver tomorrow at 6 and the reviewer on Friday at 6, basically, because now today is the 8th of June. Of course, it's only a fake project, but just to show you. And what's also cool is the translation memory is already included. So the client can attach their huge translation memory that they have onto the server, so they don't need to send you an enormous file that you can then use, right? It's all stored on their server and you can use it. So you will get matches that they have already translated before will be immediately inserted in your document. I filled this fake translation memory up a little bit. I'm curious if it will work in the test. We will do this in a second. They could also add a glossary. I haven't added one here now, but if they have some special terms, they can also add it here. So you see, you just receive a package with everything included, so you don't have to care about... You can still add your personal translation memory here if you have one, right? If you have a specific one for a maybe a topic, a source language, a target language, a client, you can still add it here, but the one from your client will already be in it. So then what you can do is start to translate. You see the document here, the name you see, and you see the number of words. So you know it's 511 words. And here you see the progress. So far, nothing has been done. So if you open this, you get into the editor. Something is messed up with the roles, but that's okay for this project. It doesn't matter. So at this stage, the translator would work on it, right? Because nothing has been done yet. And after the translator is done, reviewer one would review it, and then reviewer two would review it, and then it would go out, if the agency has two review steps included. Of course, it can always be that there is only one, or maybe not even one included. So now we are in the text editor. Now it's about translating, right? And as I mentioned to you before, I did already fill in a few things in the translation memory, and it does work. I'm very happy to see that. You see, I'm in the first segment of this document. The segmentation does memoQ does itself, right? So it's quite nice. It's usually one sentence in one segment, so it's not overwhelming to translate because you can go segment to segment. And up here top right, you see the results from the translation memory. So as you can see, this first sentence is already in the TM, right? What is lorem ipsum is was ist lorem ipsum? Was ist lorem ipsum? Not easy to say. It's already in it and it's 100% match, right? And then, of course, you don't need to translate this again, right? You can have a setting, I think, that it immediately adds it to the text. I don't have this enabled now because it's a new project, a new server. But if you don't have this and you see 100% match, you see it is the first match, so it has a number 1 in the middle above the 100%. And if you want to insert it, you can just click Ctrl 1. And it inserts it and it adds a little 100% at the end, right? So you don't need to do this again. And then you want to confirm this, so you click Ctrl Enter. And then this is confirmed. The segment is, it says now it's already reviewed because it doesn't like that I'm both the translator and the reviewer. That makes sense, right? Usually in a real project, you would have different people as translator and reviewer. So it would not be here with a plus yet. This is only after the first reviewer. Überprüfer 1 means first reviewer. But in this case, it's already checked and confirmed. And then from then on, we would just simply go on with translating the next sentence. I'm not going to do it now because it's just a fake text, right? And what's really cool is if you look down here in the middle, you see a live preview of the text that you're translating, right? So whatever you haven't done yet is still English. But what you've already translated, like the title, Was ist lorem ipsum, is German, right? And whatever segment you are currently in is like has a little red square, or not a square, like a red frame around it. So I'm currently in the third segment, which is this full sentence. So you know exactly how it will look like, what it will look like in the end. That can be important for formatting issues, for example, because if German sometimes is much longer than English, right? And if this is for a magazine, you have to be careful. Sometimes it doesn't fit into a box, you know? So it's very nice to have this live preview here. And then when we come to the next title, it should give another... Yes, because I pre-translated all the titles. So as you can see up here in red, it really sticks, like it really pops out. So when you're translating and you go from this segment to the next, you see something red pops up here and you immediately know, oh, there is something. And sometimes it's not red, it's not 100% match, right? Sometimes it can be maybe a 50 or a 70 or an 80% match. That's when it finds a fragment of a sentence, but not a complete sentence that was pre-translated. If there is 100 or even 101%, you can immediately put it in, check quickly the context, but usually it's correct and you can confirm it. If there is a 70, 80% match, you can usually use it, but not exactly. Don't just control one and then enter, because it's probably not 100%, well, definitely not 100% match. That's why the tool is telling you it. Here below it, you would see if now it's 100% match. So this is the old one, this is now the new one, and this is the translation. So nothing has changed. But if it was not 100% match, you would see the new one and you would see it with kind of track changes. So you would see what is the same, what is not the same, and then you can make your adaptations based on that. But here it's 100, so we confirm it. Yeah, and you will go through the text like this, right? You will just confirm all these segments. And in the project central up here, you would always see your progress. So now we've translated 27% of a possible 100, right? And if you jump back to project central, you can then, your document stays open, so you can easily jump back very quickly. What you can also do now, of course, this translation memory is not very filled in yet, only the titles are in, but if you have a much fuller translation memory, it makes sense to search for things in there as well, right? So for example, if you are in this segment here and you see Lorem Ipsum and you remember, I've translated this before, right? Not exactly the sentence, but I've done this before. What you can then do is go on Concordance search up here with this little red pillar and the magnifying glass. And then this is a pop-up window that searches within the translation memory that is attached to the program. So if I look up here, Lorem Ipsum, and I search, then something should come up, right? And it does come up. You see like these, okay, these are just fake ones that I did before, but here the titles, it then shows you the text that, you've searched is here. So always the middle part of what you've searched is shown in the text, and then the prefix and the suffix, so you get some context with it, right? And when you click on it, you see the translation that is used down here, and you see at what time, what date, who did it as well, made this translation. Then you can kind of check if you trust this person or not, right? And if you want to use it, you can just click insert einfügen, and then it would add this translation here. Of course, in this case it's not correct, but you would still be able to look up what term was used for this Lorem Ipsum. All right, I hope this makes sense. And then once you translated everything, you would see 100% progress here in the progress bar. You would only see it in the translation part, right? Unless you are the reviewer, then you would see it here in the reviewer one. Since I am both, it does it both at the same time. I already mentioned it. But once you have this 100% complete in your role, you can then deliver this to the client. What I like to do before I deliver it, I like to export it just to check what the export looks like, right? This is a Word, so it's no problem. So you can click here on export and choose the second one. In English, it's called export dialogue. So choose this one, and then you can choose where you want to save it. So I'm going to just save it on the desktop now, and it will export the actual Word document, even though you never imported it. It came from the client, but you can still do that, right? Now, of course, this will look completely messed up because I just added like ones and numbers instead of translations, right? But it's still just to show you what happens when you export it. This is correct. It even takes the correct font, you know, Dauphin Plain as a font. And then I just added once instead, except for the titles, because they were pre-translated. And then I usually check if the formatting is correct, if there are any spelling errors, because I trust the Word spelling checker much more than any CAT tools. So I usually run a spelling check in Word. And then when this is all done, I go back to memoQ. I either insert the changes that I found in the Word, or if I didn't find any changes, then it's time to deliver. And deliver you do with this yellow little envelope here, deliver return in English. you click on it. It's probably not gonna work now for me because of the issues with the server that it's mine. But if you just click on there, it will ask you, are you sure? And you can deliver it. And then immediately the client gets an automated notification that you finished the job. Most likely, if you work with an agency, you have some kind of system that you still need to go to either tell the client you delivered it or maybe upload it. Mostly need to upload this finished export into a system of the client and then their delivered job as well. So just know if you click on the envelope, this only delivers within the memoQ workflow. Whatever the client has separately installed, you still need to do that. But that's it basically. Yeah, that's how it works. That's how I work almost every day when I get jobs from clients. There you go. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks so much to memoQ for partnering. This is the system I use the most. It's the, in my opinion, the best translation management system. Don't forget to check out the link in the description for a discount of 30%. And I see you next week with a very exciting memoQ Fest video. See you then. Bye bye.